Northern California Power Agency is located on the North Fork of the Stanislaus River. The project has the capacity to generate 250 megawatts of power. NCPA has 15 members serving 700,000 residents.
My name is Sandy Rainey. I'm the Hydro Technical Supervisor for Northern California Power Agency. The things that keep me up at night are equipment failures.
It's a burn spot.
So this is a generator stator winding Robel bar. This is a partial discharge burn area.
We have to repair this before we have a failure.
So if we take a look at the partial discharge screen, so we were running the units hot, loaded, and you can see the partial discharge here in orange start to increase. Based on this information, we scheduled an inspection, made some repairs, went into our outage, came out of the outage, and we're seeing very low levels. One of the advantages of the dynamic ratings monitoring system is a traditional coupling capacitor, which is a sensor, is installed outside the generator or possibly in here. What we have on this system is we use the RTDs that are embedded in the windings as antennas. So we install a special module. So a traditional partial discharge system would look out here. We're actually looking at this as well as with the RTDs. We can see way down into the windings. I was in the process of looking for a portable partial discharge test set. And for the amount of money that a test set would have cost, I was able to purchase a continuous monitoring system for both generators and both transformers.
The advantage of this continuous 24/7 monitoring is you see what the condition of the transformer is at operating temperature. The system that we have, we monitor the generator and the GSU main transformers. As a result of those two systems, we overlap the isophase bus. We were picking up noise external to the generator. Dynamic ratings took a look at that and said, well, approximately 14 feet from the coupler toward the transformer, there's a problem. So we scheduled an outage, went in, took a look, and basically we had loose hardware on an insulator that supports the isophase bus. It could have been a bus failure. If you are in the process of generating and you have a transformer or a bushing failure, you might be down for weeks or months, depending on if you can locate a spare transformer or find somebody that has one or get yours repaired. So having that online monitoring and seeing what's happening, that you can schedule some additional testing or investigation during the outage is critical. It's cheap insurance. It's a no-brainer.